as a guide. Pretty cool and damp today, Sunday. Okay, so I'm gonna be a bit of a copycat and port my MS311, brand new. Add two tanks through it. Still not running yet. But after seeing the 291 job that Bellhopper did, it was pretty impressive. So let's get into it. Hey Lou, everyone. I'll just take that off, but I don't think I'll be getting that off. I'll leave that AV mount on there, I think, that one. This battery on my charger, not the other one. I had this one charged, ready to go for the Dremel. In case you're wondering, this is out of warranty in June or July, one of those two. I've had it for almost 2 years and I've only used it twice. Give it a bit of a wake up. It's a lot more powerful than the 310 model, that's for sure. But now I'm into this more power stuff. Always start something over a cigarette in your bloody hand. Out of the box, these saws are restricted anyway because of the muffler. But it's got to be a way it comes out easier than that. Not really. There we go. Pull that down. There we go. Handlebars off, which doesn't leave much of the These are a clamshell. But I think your access, the screws from the top. Must be summer winter switch. Yes, it is. So I've had it on summer mode this whole time and didn't even know because I wasn't told. Maybe that's why let's see if we'll get this screw out. Doesn't matter, it can stay there. Now, I've got to take this the shroud off, which I think screwed in position underneath the. I don't want to take the carb and everything off like. Like Bill Hopper did. Might have to though. It's not an electronic carb, so. It's got to have a bit of a clean. Plus, I've got to take the limiting caps out of the carb. Also, so I may as well take it off. Just can still sort of see what I'm doing. I don't know if the limiting caps on the carb was what he was talking about yesterday when I watched the video, the part two of the 291 port job. Or it was something to do with this intake. Take the kill wire out. I might have to push it forwards again. There we go. Much like the 261, this design. That's off. Throttle linkage will have to come out as well. I know you can't see what I'm doing, but I'll show you once I've got it out. This part of the kill. Okay. That's just a tab that goes over that, and then that that went back in there. There we go. That's not going to restrict air. Okay, so the carb should pop off. Pressurized. pressure in the fuel tank, but there's no fuel in it. Jeez, that's a small Venturi. It's all right, the limiting capsule. Gotta try and get them out. We might be all right, I don't know. There's nothing on the other side of that that tells me you can excuse me, well those two, they're 225s or 7s? 225s hold those in. Straight off now. Throttle linkage, which they've made better, in my opinion, and that seals to the intake. Just like that. The third screw's there. Now it's just this shroud. I need a T25. I hope it's over here. Back in a second. Got a feeling it won't be here. T25. The T20 actually. How's everyone doing today? I was a bit bored yesterday, slept a couple of times, fell asleep, woke up, got a headache. You guys that know me pretty closely, you'll know why I gotta sleep with a machine, CPAP machine. I've got apnea, so I fell asleep without the mask on. Means I stopped breathing in my sleep. There must be a screw behind the starter. I didn't want to take the starter off. Starter off because I need to clean. You can see how much work it's done. Two tanks of fuel. That the air vane must be part of it. Not familiar with this type of saw, it's the air injection part of a John Sereed husky. So now this should just pop out. Hopefully. Somehow without. There we go. All right, now I can see the screws. There's a little. Bolt catchers, if you will. That's what they're there for, to stop the. If the bolts rattle loose and the muffler falls on the ground, if you're out cutting, these are here to stop them from you losing them. They are pretty ugly looking on the saw, but you know, they're there for that reason, stop your muffler falling off and getting lost. Jesus, they're tight. I might have to go get my T-handle back in the jiffy. Got it. That's how weak this is, so don't be alarmed, because there's no way in hell I could break anything with it. So, muffler. Where did that go? The gasket's actually riveted onto the muffler. So we'll be getting another port in there. That's what the bell hopper did. Run out of room here, I'm gonna find that screw. So, it's not crucial because I've got a bag full of steel screws. It's only 2 tanks old. Ran spanking. Well, the T handle here, I'll take this AV spring off. Crack the bottom. I don't know if these ones. Oh, wow. Oh. There'll be there's a little bit of corrosion on it because I have washed it once already. Degreaser. Oh. That's why the muffler's a bit iffy up the top. This there. Stainless. Sitting there thinking before, I was supposed to getting a phone call from the shop I bought this from, which is my local steel dealer. Well, not directly local, but I prefer to use them because the one here's useless. About the piston bearing for those 6.4 and building for East. They were supposed to ring me like 2 weeks ago. Wow, it's really on there. There must be another screw, you see? Oh no, I can see where they pry it from. Red RTV. I won't be putting it back together with that red stuff. There we go. Different to the 291. Transfer plates. You see the piston's the same as the 362. Different to the 291. And roughen the intake. Whatever glue that is, that's pretty good glue. April 24, 2019 at 9:31 PM. This was made. Still can't mean we can't port it a little bit. I mean, I don't want to take these off and not be able to get them back on. 291, it looked like it was screwed on. put that out of flying chip's reach. Thank you. roughen up the intake. Put a flushing in your grill port. Might widen the grill port. Only a little bit, not much to work with. Can open up the transfer. dust. I'll show you the difference in a second. Is interesting. Just the entrance. The entrance to the transfers. The transfers are already big from what I can see, but that's your stock standard. Poured it. Opened up a bit. The lines are sharp and restrictive. I mean, if again, one, 2 seconds in a cut, that's better than it was. It's gonna, obviously gonna have to be flushed out and everything. I'll just do a little bit more. Thank you. around about the same. Maybe not that one. That's a hell of a lot more open than it was. I should put this in a drill holder or something. Off the exhaust roof, maybe a degree or two, roughen up the intake. I didn't touch the timing. Roughen up the fresh air, the top butterfly. It's just straight air, there's no fuel mixture into that one. That's about it. The old transfers look good now. Should give it some more oomph. Now I've got to clean all the crap out. Really good too. Greaser and whatnot. I'm gonna leave the decomp open now because it's got crap in it. Why I brushed all that off? Put back together and see how she goes. That's part one. I might come back, start this compressor and blow it all out and see how I go. Maybe do part two now. Very shortly, I might take a little bit more off that. And maybe give it a degree of intake. Maybe not. I might just give it a bit more there. I'll leave you switched on for that.
Yeah.
we go. Chamfering bit. This. Done. Half an hour video for the second putt after I had to go get my tee handle. No chamfering required down here. It's not in the cylinder. Alrighty, pitch is back up when I'm at reassembly. Reassembly stage. Hooroo.